Thank you. I'm really Eero Hyvönen, and my colleagues Mikko Tolonen, Arto Mustajoki, and Anna Snellman are professors and deans from the University of Helsinki. I come actually from double universities, Aalto University and University of Helsinki, which are both actually the two biggest universities in Finland. And we have now established this new Helsinki Center for Digital Humanities that I will be talking about. So the next question, or first question that came to my mind when I started to direct this new institute is, what is digital humanities? And I have noticed that everybody is asking still the same question after all these years. And I will give a short answer to that, and then a little bit more about the Heldig Center that we are now starting. So the idea, if you go to this whatsdigitalhumanities.com, you will find over 800 different definitions or discussions of what it is. And it's very typical humanist approach. Instead of answering what it is, you start a discussion. And that's a way to go. But we as computer scientists started then to analyze more what these answers actually mean. And probably if you do some data mining and clustering here, you will come up with something like this. That's at least what I came up, that we have computer science and informatics, then we have humanities and social sciences, and you mix the drink, and there you have the cocktail of digital humanities. In more particular terms, we actually focus on two different ways of approaching this. First, using computational methods in humanist and social science research. So this is a kind of methodological thing that Gerhard was speaking in his nice talk before me. And then we also study digitalization as a phenomenon. So many humanists really like to study what's happening here in the world, like on the web, without using digital means at all. And I think this is fine as well. This is very important. The digitalization is too serious thing to be left for the engineers only. So what about our center then? This is actually a major profiling initiative in Finland. Our Ministry of Education and Culture got a very brilliant idea. Every year they take about 50 million euros from the budget of the universities and education. And then they tell us, apply, change, make something new out of that money. And we can, all the universities are free to apply, make kind of profiling applications. The idea there is not just to apply for project funding, but something that deeply changes the way universities collaborate and work. And actually, our research center was successful in this application, where the idea was to change the way that humanities and social sciences are done in the long run at the University of Helsinki and in the larger perspective as well. And so we got funding, and we have about a budget of 10 million euros in the coming 3 years for making this happening. So it's something that we try to change in the university, so that more and more computational methods are being used in humanities and social sciences, and also that we can then change something for the next generation of researchers that we are educating. We had our kickoff symposium in October the 5th with over 200 participants, so it was also a kind of sign that people are really excited in Finland about this idea. What we do in practice, or where the money goes, we will be establishing 8 new tenure-track professorships in the coming years, and they will have also personnel, one PhD student and one postdoc researcher, basically the idea with sort of resourcing also these professorships. And we also coordinate existing digital humanities resources in University of Helsinki and beyond. And actually there's lots of things happening now that I've started to look more closely. And myself, I didn't know that I'm a digital humanist researcher actually, although I have been doing this for 15 years and even gave an invited keynote at the Digital Humanities Center in 2008, but that was the only conference I attended in this arena. Because I'm a computer scientist, I attend computer science conferences, and now I will be more around in digital humanities conferences. So you can see, and I see this happening not only for me, but also many other fields. There are lots of very good linguists, for example, and corporate researchers at the University of Helsinki, and they didn't know perhaps that they are digital humanists. but I hope that, after a couple of years we get more sort of kind of identity of this group of people that are working with computational methods in humanities. This is a networking organization. It's not on the University of Helsinki, but beyond that. And for example, I was invited to direct this center from another university. I think this is a sign that we are really thinking this in broader terms than just as an internal event in one university. So the door is open. Welcome to Heldig Network, and this invitation is also to all of you, because of course this is something not happening in only Finland or Helsinki area, but internationally. And that's the interesting part of that, I think, because this is an international effort, of course. At the University of Helsinki, there are actually 7 different faculties involved. Faculty of Arts is a coordinator. We have something like over 60 professors. That's a major faculty in this area. Then we have behavioral sciences, learning kind of things on digital era. Biological and environmental sciences are also involved. They are doing like things like how political decision making relates to climate change. They're very, very good groups actually in this area at our university. Faculty of Law, we are publishing linked open data, Finnish law and legislation as linked open data, for example. And this is very popular topic, of course, related to copyrights and my data and things like that. Faculty of Science, computer scientists are, of course, a very important factor in our initiative. And Faculty of Social Sciences, of course, very important. The computational and quantitative methods they are using there. And then we also have some blessing from above, because Faculty of Theology is also involved in our initiative. The vision is that Helsinki area will be a leading international hub of digital humanities research, education, development in a couple of years. And I think that many groups there are already internationally very, very well established, but we want to bring all this together and make it a more coherent to the outside as well. From an organizational perspective, we have a director now, and a coordinator is now starting to work. And then we have a couple of professors and other activists working on the Heldig related matters. So we have a kind of core group. But the professorships, for example, will be established in the existing faculty, so there will not be a skyscraper of Heldig or something like that in Helsinki Center, but something else. We will have a management board where we have representatives from participating faculties. And then an advisory board, and I think this is very important. Representatives from collaborating organizations. We are trying to collect museums, archives, libraries, and so on to this network. And for example, in my own research group, I just counted that during the 10 last years, we have had 50 different organizations funding the research, many of which are from cultural heritage organizations. Even if the amount of money might have been little, but it shows that it really is, people are interested in collaborating with academics, and we should sort of foster this kind of collaborations. I think this is very important. This is not just an academic effort, but we need the environment there and companies and the other stakeholders involved. So a linguistic perspective to Heldig, it actually means lucky, successful, favorable, beneficial, advisable, suitable, happy, and so on. This is actually a Norwegian, and Danish Birte can perhaps confirm that it is. So we hope this will be an omen. The strategy then, there will be 4 major areas that we're involved: research, education, infrastructures, and society. This is not perhaps very, very new to you now that I have heard a few presentations of the other DH centers. But on research, as I mentioned, we focus on introducing and using more computational methods in digital humanities research and studying digitalization as a phenomenon. When we made this proposal to the ministry, we actually could identify over 60 University of Helsinki professors mentioned as kind of research, or they were professors who were involved in some way to digital humanities in a very broad sense, which was a kind of news to us. And then we will establish these new professorships. That is the main initiative here. And the tracks will be something like this. This is still open to discussion, but it's divided into two parts. First, computational methodologies and tools for digital humanities, where we have a digital humanities professorship, which is just now being filled up, actually. Data analytics in humanities and social sciences, digital social science, digital innovations in consumer behavior, big data learning analytics. And then another area will be digital humanities and globalization, which is more focusing on studying digitalization, global interactions, religion and digital world, Russian big data methodology, and legal research on digitalization. So it's difficult to say what kind of professors we will be having, but this is sort of the big picture, and now these different faculties are thinking of a more precise formulations of what kind of professors will be then involved in this network. The network then expands. Now Aalto University and University of Helsinki has been sort of active there, but also University of Arts is involved. And other research organizations in Helsinki area, we are discussing with them. Lots of libraries, museums, and archives that we are already collaborating at the moment. And media organizations are important because they are producing the history of tomorrow companies. And also these EU infrastructure initiatives. We already have the Clarin node at Heldig, and now we are discussing with Daria. Aalto University just got cooperative status in Daria, and University of Helsinki is joining as well in the next round. And then of course, all kinds of collaborations with international collaborators. For example, in my own case, we are working with lots of universities, like with Oxford and Stanford, and lots of universities collaborations in Europe as well. So this is very important for us. On the education side, we already have established a digital humanities minor, which has two major parts. Theory and practice, there is one introductory course to digital humanities, and then lots of courses that students can select from. And then a methodological part where you have one major course introducing different kinds of statistical and other methods for digital humanities, and then you can deepen your expertise on various other courses. And then the whole thing ends up with a kind of hackathon kind of thing where everybody picks up a digital humanities project and then make some kind of really working stuff out of the data using computational methods. And we are now, that the new center is now established, where we are working on how to make this minor into a major, and also the PhD program would be very, very important, I think. But it's not that easy, I think. There you must have something, more discussions. The idea of Heldig is not just to teach our students, but as was mentioned already in the previous talks, it's very important that we can make the change in the research that the practitioners and researchers that are already there in the universities and do not know how to use these new methods. So we are trying to address also these people. For example, we are creating interactive teaching materials like now we'll be publishing this linked data school Linda, which has this kind of idea that researchers who don't come to these ordinary courses then could also try to learn by themselves online these new technologies, and of course there's lots of material around on the web, so even collecting that together and providing that to the researchers and telling that this is good stuff please have a look at it. Would be also very useful and can be done very cheaply, actually. On infrastructures, I think this is very important and close to my own heart because I'm original computer scientist. So data production and publication and tooling using these in digital humanities research, and then also to foster open data and open source. So that's also on our agenda. As mentioned, we are now already a kind of member, collaborative member of DARIA, and we have been actually working on building national Finnish semantic web infrastructure since 2003 in Finland. With the University of Helsinki and Aalto University in major Finnish initiatives. So there was this FinOnto project and where we built, for example, ontology services that are now in use actually in Finland. So actually linked data and semantic web is already happening in Finland, not only at academia, but also in practice. There's also lots of language technology research in Finland, like we have this Clari network, and when we have Varien group that's working on English language, and we have lots of data mining, visualization, knowledge discovery work at computer science department. So lots of things are happening already, and this can be used then or packaged for. Not only for the one research group that developed the system, but also for the others to use. And I think this is one of our goals, to make this good stuff that other groups are making there available for other people, so that they won't be just used by some few people, but can be reused by others as well. So I would like to quote here our friend Al, who said that intellectuals solve problems, geniuses prevent them. And I think this work on infrastructures is exactly for this, even if he wasn't a digital humanist, although he was a humanist. So here's some examples that we have been working on to give more flesh on the bones. So this Onki ontology service, for example, that we developed in a course of 10 years, it contains all major vocabularies transformed into a system of linked open ontologies in Finland and put then on an online service so that, for example, museums can use them through web services in their cataloging systems. And we created this system first as a university prototype, and then we had some hundreds of museums and other organizations that were really using it. Then it was too late for the Ministry of Education to stop funding it. And so it happened 2 years ago that they gave money to the National Library to deploy this system. And it's now online free system for everybody to use. And it's on a sort of kind of a sustainable basis. Now that's what was the original idea there, but it took, I must say, it was frustrating years, 10 years to convince people that this is a good thing and you should believe in linked data and semantic web. And now that the thing is happening, then it's of course easy to say afterwards that we were right. We are now working also on other ontology services. For example, this is a picture of the Finnish ontology service for historical places and maps, where we are dealing with the problem of that we not only need current gazetteers as ontology services, but also the historical places, which change a lot. For example, this area that you see in this picture, it's an annexed area by the Soviet Union after the Second World War, and we created there an ontology of over 30,000 different places geo-coded there, because these places don't exist anymore, most of them. The Russians either destroyed the places or changed the names of the places into some like Leningrad and things. So it was area that was sort of Russianized after the war. And for example, in this kind of situations, you have very dramatic changes in the gazetteer world. You won't find anything. And also on the more current maps, and we also have the old maps there. And that's of course important as well, because you cannot find these old Finnish places on the modern Google Maps anymore. So we actually digitized the old maps there, and you can look at them then semi-transparently on top of the modern maps and find out the real places that are there. And then you can have there also things like Getty, DGN and other stuff as well. And compare, actually. It was very interesting to, for example, compare how DGN maps to the Finnish gazetteers, and it's a very big changes, actually. So you cannot trust the foreigners for making this kind of stuff. The local authorities are much of course better there. Then the thing that we have been working on is on data publishing is Linked Data Finland platform, LDFI. Where the idea is to provide a linked open data service in the same way as these ontology services were provided. So it's I'll speed up. Yeah, the idea there is that Tim Berners-Lee introduced these five stars, and we thought that because there are seven-star hotels, at least one in the world, why don't we make a seven-star linked data model? And we had two new stars, where the idea is to promote even further reuse of linked data. The sixth star comes if you provide documentation, the schema of your data, and seventh star if you validate your data, so that we have some kind of trust on the quality of the data that you're providing. And we have actually about 100 data sets already there, like Finnish DPpedia, lexicons, cultural heritage stuff, Finnish history, ontology, even Kalevala as a semantic web, the EPIC, Finnish law, geodata, university data of Aalto University, linked science, ornithological observations, ontologies, media news and weather data, for example. Lots of stuff, and everything is open. And then the fourth strategic point is society. So we, of course, foster. We think that this is important. The digital humanities research is important for the science, for the society, to make decisions and to foster then open research and science. Quite a few events already took place. Some international ones. We had just had a conference on philosophy and the history of open science. That was very very popular. In summary. Heldig is a new major strategic initiative at the University of Helsinki, and it's based on digital humanities activities at the Faculty of Arts. But it's a networking organization beyond University of Helsinki. We are working on the infrastructure side with linked open data infrastructures, ontology services, and so on, that I showed a few examples here. And there are lots of new activities underway that we hope we can report on next conference like this. Thank you.
Thank you very much. We have just for one very short question because we are late. Yes, please.
Okay, my question is, are the eight professorships part of the center or are they part of the disciplines or both?
They are part of the faculty, so there will not be a sort of separate institute like that. Yeah, but we are then trying to build it so that this would create kind of
So thank you once again very much, and our next speaker has not come, so now we have time for coffee, 25 minutes, and we are welcome after coffee back. Thank you once again.